Dear teachers, welcome to Diploma in Elementary Education program. I am Madhur Bhatia, the course coordinator of course 501, Elementary Education in India, a socio-cultural perspective. As teachers of elementary class children, we shoulder a great responsibility for their overall development and learning. We need to be equipped with required knowledge and skills to help children develop to their best potential. With this, let us have an overview of the course titled as Elementary Education in India, a Socio-Cultural Perspective. This course presents an overview of the elementary education at the national and global levels, covering the historical progression of elementary education. The course will help you understand the nature and development of elementary education in a holistic way. Before starting any course, we must be familiar with its learning objectives. After studying this course, it is expected that you are able to develop an understanding of various initiatives taken for universalization of elementary education, including District Primary Education Program, Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, and Right to Education Act. You would also be able to reflect on issues and challenges being faced by elementary education at national and international levels. This course carries 4 credits equivalent to 120 study hours. There are 3 blocks in this course titled as Block 1, Elementary Education in India, a Retrospect, Block 2, Elementary Education in India in the Contemporary Context 1, and Block 3, Elementary Education in India in the Contemporary Context 2. Let us have an overview of Block 1. In this block, you will study about historical perspective of Indian education system from ancient times to pre-independence period. This block covers the significant recommendations of committees and commissions with reference to elementary education in the pre- and post-independence period. You will also study about the need and organizational structure of universalization of elementary education. Accordingly, this block has been divided into 4 units titled as Unit 1, Indian Education System 1, Unit 2, Indian Education System 2, Unit 3, Education as a Fundamental Right. Organizational structure for universalization of elementary education is Unit 4 of this block. Now let's understand Block 2, which is Elementary Education in India in the Contemporary Context 1. This block talks about initiatives taken and strategies implemented for universalization of elementary education. It also highlights planning and management of universalization of elementary education at micro and macro levels. You will find 3 units in this block in continuation with the previous units. Unit 5, Strategies for Universalization of Elementary Education 1. Unit 6, Strategies for Universalization of Elementary Education 2, the Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan. Unit 7, Planning and Management of Universalization of Elementary Education. The last block of course 1 is Block 3, which is Elementary Education in India in the Contemporary Context 2. This block helps you to study about models of elementary teacher education, National Curriculum Framework 2005, National Curriculum Framework for Teacher Education, that is NCFTE 2009, pedagogical issues and concerns of the primary and upper primary substage of elementary education. Now the most important aspect, that is teacher as a reflective practitioner, has also been dealt. Implementation of the teacher eligibility test has also been elaborated. This block discusses about preparing for education of the disadvantage encompassing empowering teachers to protect child rights in schools. Initiatives for elementary education in developing and developed countries and role of international agencies in universalization of elementary education are the significant parts of this block. Accordingly, there are 3 units. Unit 8, preparing teachers for elementary education. Unit 9, preparing teachers for education of disadvantaged. And Unit 10, International Scenario in Elementary Education. To summarize, there are total 3 blocks and 10 units in course 1. I request your active participation in the course. For further information, you can contact me. I wish you all the best for your future.